While I've seen over 70 movies this year in theaters, some of them I just missed, or some of them released only in limited release, and so I haven't been able to catch them yet. So on the screen, you're seeing a couple movies which aren't going to be listed on any of these lists. Here's the best of 2015, as brought to you by IAYTD. All right, welcome back to I'm Your Target Demographic. This is the time you've all been waiting for. This is the top 10 movies of 2015 for me. Again, I've seen about 70 movies. You saw at the beginning of the videos, the one that they're not going to be on here is I never got to see them, so I don't know if Revenant will make the top 10. I also want to preface, these may not be the best movies of the year, but they're my favorites. It's my top 10. So there's going to be movies that maybe scored less than other movies that didn't make the list, whatever. Don't worry about it, but these are my 10, and looking back at the year, my 10 favorite. I do have a number 11, an honorable mention, and that is Straight Outta Compton. Just a really great movie. I knew literally nothing about that story, even though I know a couple songs, whatever, but I found that story incredibly interesting, great performances, and just a really compelling look at that slice of history. And if you haven't seen it, find it. Really cool movie, Straight Outta Compton. So number 10, I'm going with Spotlight. Spotlight is a fantastic movie. And when it comes to Oscar season and award season in general, it's gonna win a lot. But for me, it's only number 10 because I never want to re-watch Spotlight. It's just a huge downer. It's kind of hard to watch. It's super interesting. Great performances, but I don't really want to ever see it again. So Spotlight, for me, sits at number 10, but it is going to sweep the awards. At number 9, we've got the Steven Spielberg, Tom Hanks Cold War drama, Bridge of Spies, where Tom Hanks' character has to negotiate a trade with a USSR spy that we've captured, but he's not really suited for this. He's just like a normal guy. Super compelling movie, really interesting. Tom Hanks is great, but Tom Hanks is Tom Hanks. But for me, Mark Rylance as the supporting actor, which you saw from my supporting actor video, nails it. Great work here. Bridge of Spies. And number 8, I'm going my favorite comedy of the year, and that is Trainwreck. Amy Schumer is great, the supporting cast is great, just really funny and deep in a way that I wasn't expecting. I was expecting like a Judd Apatow kind of, what he's traditionally known for, and interestingly enough, he did direct this movie, so that's why I was expecting that again. You know, but this gave us more, and I think it's because Amy Schumer wrote from what I suspect to be a lot of her past history. Just she nails it. Great witty writing, great performances. Trainwreck is fantastic. And number 7, I'm going Kingsman: The Secret Service. Kingsman is just an action-packed popcorn adventure ride. Like, there's not a lot of substance, but the fight scenes are incredible. The action scenes are great. Some great new talent. Colin Firth kicks ass, which I did not expect. Just such a fun movie, and it came out in like February when no one was expecting good movies to come out. And it just wowed. And a lot of people are saying it's their favorite superhero movie of 2015, and I totally understand why. Because I think it is the highest superhero movie on my list because it was based on a graphic novel. So I guess it is my favorite superhero movie of 2015 too. And number 6, we've got Creed. Creed is just a great story. It harkens back to Rocky in the original Rocky movies, but it's so much more. And that's gonna be the theme of a couple movies on this list, where it kind of retells the same points, but it just nails it. Michael B. Jordan is great as always. Sylvester Stallone gives the performance of his career, you know, or at least the last 30 years. Just great stuff, great one-take action scenes. So if you haven't seen Creed, it should still be in theaters. Go see it. It'll be well worth your money. Even if you haven't seen the other Rocky movies, go see Creed. And number 5, I'm going with Sicario. And Sicario is a story of Emily Blunt, who's brought in to do this investigation of kind of this drug ring in Mexico, but there's a lot of layers to it, and she's kind of in the dark about it, so she's kind of the puppet that's being kind of told what to do, and she's trying to figure out why are things happening, who are these people, and she's with this character played by Benicio del Toro, who's kind of this mysterious character that knows a lot more than he's letting on. So it's a story of them kind of trying to take down this drug ring, but what's really happening? It's violent, it's intense, some great action sequences, great performance by both Emily Blunt and Benicio Del Toro. Just great. If you haven't seen it, go rent it, Sicario. At number 4, I'm going with one of my favorite Pixar movies of all time, Inside Out. Now, Inside Out surprised me. I thought it was going to be their first bust, which turned out to be the Good Dinosaur. But I thought this was going to be it. I was like, I don't know about this. Emotions? Is that enough to make a movie? The answer is yes. And it nails it. I cried like a baby. It had so many moments that you kind of are nostalgic for, but it's someone else's life. You know, like, but you can kind of like superpose them on your own life and you totally get what this girl's going through. Just super funny, super touching, fantastic. If I were to put a top five list of Pixar movies, that would be on my top five for sure, Inside Out. At number three, I'm going The Martian. The Martian came out early enough where I was like, oh, this isn't really gonna be like an Oscar movie, but it totally is. It has a chance for best movie of the year. It has a chance for best actor of the year with Matt Damon. Just incredible performances. He carries this movie almost by himself, yet they managed to get incredible talent to have kind of in these supporting roles. You know, when you get Chiwetel Ejiofor, you get Jeff Daniels, you get Jessica Chastain, you get these huge names that are just complementing what Matt Damon is doing, and it works perfectly. The Martian is a great, great movie. Don't sleep on The Martian. Like, find it, watch it, trust me. I loved it. Now, my top two are gonna be the same top two as a lot of other people that I watch and respect, but I'm gonna flip the verse here. And at number two, I've got Star Wars: The Force Awakens. Now, Star Wars, I'm a huge Star Wars fan. Before the extended universe was scrapped, I read, as a kid, probably 100, you know, or at least like 50 of these novels that were based on their kids and then their kids, and here's a story about this random guy in a bar. Like all these little facets of the Star Wars world I was obsessed with. So I was really hesitant about a new movie coming out because I was burned once before. But The Force Awakens is incredible. And I might even say it's one of the best Star Wars movie, not the fourth best, one of the best Star Wars movies. It does echo a lot of very similar beats as the first movie, but so does Creed. You know, so do other movies. You know, like, it's normal to reference and kind of come full circle on those things, and Star Wars does it great. The new characters are more interesting than the old characters, which is a great sign. I want to know what these new people are going to do. Where are they going to go? The music, fantastic. The special effects, fantastic. The villain, way cooler than anything we've seen in a long time. There's some deepness there. There's intricacies. There's mystery. Just The Force Awakens, incredible at number two. So that means at number one, my favorite movie of the year, and the movie that has been listed on a lot of these videos as number one, is Mad Max. Mad Max, I think I saw four times in theaters. I bought it on Blu-ray. I've watched it multiple times since then. It is just mesmerizing. The way that it takes place entirely in a desert, and yet it is immensely colorful. The action is non-stop. There is a strong female lead that kicks ass. It is just, there's so many factors that make Mad Max an incredible experience. And it's great to see the original director, George Miller, come back from the original Mad Max movies. Between then and now, he directed a couple movies, most notably Happy Feet and Happy Feet 2. So it's great to see him come back to what made him and make a movie that is absolutely fantastic. So by now, if you've seen all these videos, you've heard me tell you so many times how Mad Max is incredible, you need to go see it. It might be overhyped for you. Okay, that happens. Where because so many people tell you it's good, you eventually see it and you're like, that's okay. So I hope that's not the case. If it is, tell me. If you saw it and legitimately didn't like parts, tell me. Feel free to disagree. If you saw Mad Max and loved it, also put that in the comments. Tell me what your top 10 is. Out of all the movies you've seen this year, what were your favorites? They don't have to be the best movies. You know, Spotlight wasn't my number one, but it was an incredible movie. So put your top 10. Let me know what your favorites were. This was a lot of videos, so thank you for watching all of these. This was a lot of work, but hopefully you found these interesting. Hopefully this told you about movies that you didn't really know about or you weren't super excited about, and now you are. That was the point of doing all this. So thanks for watching. Make sure you head over to facebook.com/IAYTD. Give us a like. We do a lot of conversations and stuff there you can contribute to. And thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe. All that stuff. Thanks.